We will take roll for the record. Mrs. Carbone?
Here.
Mr. Darling? Mr. Dreyer?
Here.
Mr. Hulse? Mr. Lynch?
Here.
Mrs. Mallon? Mrs. Shaw? Mrs. Soltis? Mr. Petcha?
Here.
We have quorum.
Thank you. Thank you. All right, we're going to just go a little bit out of order again. We are going to move resolution number 97, which is hand carried. William, will you please move resolution number 97?
Sure. I'd like to move resolution 97, appointment director of human resources.
I second.
Thank you. Let's take a vote.
Mrs. Carbone?
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer?
Oh, it's not working?
Yes.
They're flashing green, some of them. I don't know.
Oh, now it's back on. Yes.
Duly noted.
Oh, there it goes.
First, then it'll come on. So just do that.
My vote is still yes.
Thank you. Mr. Hulse?
Yes.
Mr. Lynch?
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw?
Yes.
Mrs. Soltis?
Yes.
Mr. Petcha?
Yeah, I'll just leave it like that.
Yeah. It's really only supposed to take about five on, but why don't we just leave them on, especially you?
Yes.
Thank you. Motion carried.
All right. Dr. Rubin, I'm going to throw it to you.
That was the hardest vote ever.
I mean, I could restart it, but it's going to take
here,
this.
Doc. There you go.
I think we're good. Perfect. Back to the gym. So what the board just voted on is naming Michael Callahan as our new director of human resources. We'll have a press release going out today. The Cranford Board of Education is pleased to announce Michael Callahan as the director of human resources. Mr. Callahan was selected after an extensive search process, which included multiple interviews with the selection committee and a very thorough reference check. Mr. Callahan, who began his career with the Somerville Public Schools in 2003 as a teacher and team leader, currently oversees a staff of over 1,000 as Director of Human Resources for the Hillsborough Township Public Schools. Previous to that tenure, he served the Hillsborough Township Public Schools as a district supervisor. Michael Callahan holds a bachelor's degree from the University of Rochester, Eastman School of Music, and a master's degree in educational administration from Caldwell University, and he's pursuing doctoral studies at the University of St. Elizabeth. Please join me in welcoming Michael Callahan.
Thank you. What an amazing evening, celebrating so much goodness here in Cranford. I mean, so much incredible goodness here in Cranford. To all the staff members who were recognized tonight, wow, sincerely inspiring. What can one say about professionals that bring such remarkable goodness to our students, except for thank you for who you are and thank you for what you do. Over the past few weeks, it's been amazing to get to know Dr. Rubin and his first class team. I'm very much looking forward to more of the same. And tonight, I'd just like to sincerely thank Dr. Rubin and you, the board, for your warm welcome. As a lifelong resident of New Jersey, I'm extremely humbled, I'm extremely motivated, and I'm extremely elated to serve the wonderful community of Cranford.
And Michael, just so you know, we do that every time. That is our template board meeting that you just saw here tonight. So excellent. As we move on, we've talked about the anti-bullying Bill of Rights that was passed, I guess, in 2011 by this point, right? 2011, 2012, somewhere around there. And so we've got certain reporting requirements that occur every year. One of them is a self-assessment. We actually completed that and submitted that to the state in October, and I guess it is now May. That was just approved, and so we got that in a timely manner. And so what we've done is I provided that to the board as per the requirement. We also posted it to the website, so it's on there. If you go to Board of Ed information, there's a link there for anti-bullying, and you'll can see the self-assessment. It ranges. The max score you can get is a 78. The lowest score we have is a 75. All the schools are doing wonderfully in terms of training and providing supportive programming throughout the district. So I just want to thank Lisa Burfeind, who oversees that as our anti-bullying coordinator, and of course Gail Colucci, our district coordinator for culture and climate. And honestly, it's everybody. It's the counselors, it's the principals, it's the teachers, it's the students, it's the administrators. This isn't just any one particular individual that helps us create and foster a wonderful community like we have in Cranford, but it's a whole team working together. So we certainly appreciate everyone for what they're doing. But again, as per the requirement, that is up on the website. At the end of the school year, we just have so many different activities. They're really too numerous to list, but you can take a look at the various calendars at each of the schools. There is really, I mean, there's always a lot going on in Cranford, you know, in a regular month, but especially towards the end of the school year, it gets very busy. I want to thank Nikki Savino and her crew for Relay for Life this past weekend. It was an outstanding and important event. All the students, all the people that spoke, it was really just a very important event, and I appreciated being able to be there as a part of it. I also just recently saw our joint honor society. We had our honor societies combined for the first time. It was really a momentous event. Very nice. Got to take in the baseball game, at least a couple innings of it, before flying back there. And so congratulations to baseball and softball for winning those tournaments. We had our strategic planning session. I guess it was last week. Feels like last week. See, the last week. Yeah, I think it was last week or the week before. That was our fourth session, and we've got our fifth session coming up in a couple of weeks. Everyone can play along with that. We post the items and the agendas and the work products up on the website, and there's also a feedback form there as well. So if people want to provide input, and we certainly hope that you do, into the process, you can go ahead and share it through those means. I also want to shout out to our police department. I was had the pleasure of going to one of their award ceremony last week and celebrating all the heroism, all of them just absolutely phenomenal. It was a pleasure to be there to celebrate them, and certainly what they do for our township in general, Herculean, but especially what they do for our schools. We cannot thank them and the rest of the safety professionals enough for all they do. And then finally, we celebrated our Teachers of the Year this month, and in a short period of time, I guess at our next board meeting, we're also going to celebrate our retirees. So we're certainly looking forward to that as well. And that is my report.
Thank you, Dr. Rubin. Does any board member have any questions or comments for Dr. Rubin? Okay, Bob, I'm gonna throw it to you.
No report.
All right, thank you, Bob. Okay, does any board member have any communication they would like to share? William.
Thank you. A few board members attended the Booster Club dinner about a week ago. I just want to give a shout out to Darren Torzone, the volunteers that ran the Booster Club dinner for our seniors. It was very nice. Bob Bruns, Mrs. Delmore, there were several people involved with that. It's been done for a very long period of time. So they put a lot of effort in that. I know Patrick's our liaison, but we did get to attend. So I just want to make sure that they're, you know, we recognize them. They put a lot into that night at the for that dinner. So just want to say thank you.
Thank you, William. Anybody else? Good. All right. We're going to move on to our first audience participation. If anybody would like to come up, make any comments, ask any questions, just please come up to the mic, state your name and address.
Your theme music, Mr. Hurley.
Thank you very much. Rich Hurley, president of CA. I just want to let you know, Mr. Halls, the first Booster Club dinner I went to was when I was in high school, so that's how long it is, at least. So I'm not sure when it's at the Westwood. So it's still there. It hasn't moved in 40 plus years. I just want to welcome Mr. Callahan to Cranford. I think he did a good job finding a new HR director. So I think he's going to be a pretty good fit in Cranford, and we're all looking forward to working with him. Also want to congratulate all the teachers who were honor tonight and thank all of you for doing that. It's a nice little thing. You know, somebody here mentioned that very often, you know, being on the school board is a thankless job, and I know for a fact that it is, but sometimes doing what we do is a thankless job. So every once in a while, it's really nice to hear that. Thank you. So thank you very much for honoring them and everybody else. And like everybody else, I was very surprised by Dr. Rubin's honor tonight. And I want to say congratulations. Very well deserved. As you all know, Dr. Rubin and I have been working very closely together since he started here. And, you know, there's a lot of good things that have been happening in Cranford. We don't agree all the time, but we get a little, we're able to work out most of our differences and, you know, very much, I believe, to the benefit of the kids, the staff, and the community. So congratulations.
Thank you, Rich. Well, I appreciate your partnership. Thank you.
Anybody else?
Good evening.
Good.
Dr. Rubin, Dr. Heineman, board members, thank you for taking the moment to listen to me this evening. My name is Christopher Crockle. I'm a resident here in Cranford. My daughter attends kindergarten at BAS, and my son is in third grade at OAS. I am here on behalf of my wife, who is here with me, myself, as well as many other Cranford families with school-aged children. I'm a cum laude graduate from Berklee School of Music. I'm a nationally and internationally known jazz musician and educator. I play 12 different instruments. I've taught music for 32 years, ranging from PhD programs to kindergarten and everything in between. My wife, Christina, who is here with me, is a professional stage manager. She has had an illustrious career on Broadway and regionally worked for 3 seasons at Paper Mill Playhouse, 4 years on Broadway's Lion King, and most recently 14 years as assistant stage manager on Wicked. She has taught students for over 17 years and has done a master class at many prestigious universities. I have 3 basic statements I need to make to all of you tonight. The first is I'm here to help the children of Cranford. The second is that music, visual arts, dance, and theater are not luxuries for a select few. And lastly, the state mandated law for the curriculum of music, visual arts, dance, and theater is not being taught in Cranford, period. We are here to make all of you aware of the meeting we had with Dr. Rubin, Dr. Heineman, on March 28th of this year. Also in attendance was Ms. Atkinson, BAS music teacher Colleen McDonald, and BAS principal Kristen Diana. In that meeting, we had a chance to explain our concerns regarding the inequality, discrimination, and current inability to reach the standards mandated by the New Jersey Department of Education for the 4 disciplines of music, visual arts, dance, and theater. As music and arts professionals, my wife and I presented a few key areas that need to be addressed. We explained how to simply fix them and how to bring together the school administration, faculty, and the families in order to do so. I was not aware of what was happening earlier tonight, and I have to say, it was impressive, and it's wonderful to see teachers and educators be given awards, especially in the fields that I saw. More so for Dan Chernowski, that when I met him back in January, we went to Berklee together, and I didn't realize that at the time. We sort of crossed paths. I was there a little bit before him. And to me, there's a lot of great things going on at Cranford, and it's an opportunity to expand on it, but also to say, when there isn't something that is working, we need to work together. May I be allowed to finish? Yes, I will. I'm sorry about that. I represent an increasing number of Cranford parents and students who have personally spoken to my wife and myself regarding these concerns. Cranford should not only be known for having a thriving community that cares about its residents, but also known as a town that dedicates its future to all children, not only in academic and athletic strengths, but in the disciplines of music, visual arts, dance, and theater. For the 6th consecutive year, Westfield Public School District was named one of the best communities of music education in the nation. It was awarded this by NAM, National Association of Music Merchants. The Cranford school system has an opportunity to do the same or better. It is my hope that you will work with Dr. Rubin and his team, and that you will also call on all professionals such as myself, my wife, and many of the residents of Cranford that work in the music and arts industry each and every day to make these arts programs and the town of Cranford the envy of all in New Jersey. Thank you for your time.
Hi there. My name's Tracy Tully. I live at 405 Manor Avenue. First, congratulations, Dr. Rubin. That's really great, and what a point of pride for the town. Congratulations, that's really great. I have a teeny tiny concern, which actually, talking with Mr. Canigallo outside, I'm probably wasting your time. It's not a board issue. It's a Cranford High issue, but since I'm here, I'll mention it. And I think you are familiar with it because he mentioned that he'd spoken to me about it. It's about this a rule in the school handbook at Cranford High that relates to taking, the kids are in the AP classes and they taking the final exams. So as it's currently written, and I think this predates probably everybody in this room, pretty much maybe everybody, but it's not a new rule because it affects, I think, my older guys, but I just never paid attention because I never screwed up like I did this year, and I'll explain. If you take an AP class and you take the AP exam, and you pay your $85 or your $110, you take the AP exam, and you get an 85 or at least an 85 in the class, you're exempt from the final exams for the AP class. So what happened this year is it's a two-step registration process. You have to register with College Board, which my daughter did, and then you have to do a separate payment process through the high school, which I failed to do, thinking that it was already done, whatever. So we didn't even realize it until it was too late. I called College Board, I tried to get it, whatever. She couldn't take the test, neither of them. But then as I started looking at the rule, and I didn't realize that then she'd have to, anyway, I looked at the rule, and it's so illogical, because if you take the AP test, if you get a 1 or 2, it has 0 effect on your grade. But if you have to take a final, and it's 10%, in other years I realize that might not be weighted like that this year, but typically it could have a definite effect on your grade, you know, from going from an 87 to an 85. That's a big difference GPA-wise in any event. But it could more importantly, it could have a positive effect if you game the system and decide, well, if I'm already taking all the AP tests that I could possibly, Yale's ever going to accept, you know, and I may as well just not take it, and I'll do better than the person I'm competing with as salutatorian. Like, I could see the salutatorian and the valedictorian coming down to, like, whisker-thin, you know, GPA differences. And smart kids, they're going to figure this out. It's just illogical. And not to mention that the school doesn't realize that a kid hasn't registered to take it because, you know, their mom failed to do it like I did, or they don't have the $110. They don't realize it. The school does not realize it until it's too late. And when you're taking 3 or 4 classes and it's 110 or 95 or 85 if you register early, that's a lot of money. Yeah, I think it's really a Cranford High issue, and so I'm sorry for taking your time, but I do think it's something that needs to be reviewed because I think it makes no sense. Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Do we have anybody else who wants to speak? No. Yeah. Want to take the music first? Or Ms. Tully?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you. So, thank you for the opportunity. Mrs. Tully, what we'll do is, it sounds like you're already in communication with Mr. Canigallo, so I would continue with those. I know Mr. Canigallo did reach out to us to give us just sort of like the highlights of that piece there. It would be helpful for you to know that Dr. Heineman is literally, as we speak, leading an effort and has been for a while now to take a look at assessment, homework, assessments, all of those things, tests in general, which would include these kinds of policies, sending out surveys to faculty, working with them, to parents, to students, and the like. So that is something that we're taking a look at, those policies. As you said, it did predate us, but we are taking a look at all those things. To be honest, I don't know how quickly we can move on something that's already in the program of studies and that's been going on for a while, but let's have Mr. Canigallo at least, work with you and also work with Dr. Heineman, see what can be done. But that is something we are taking a look at.
Not likely to happen this year, which I
And Mrs. Tully, I apologize. We can talk offline the way that, and I apologize. It's not a public Q&A. It's public comment. Once you provide your comments, then, you know, I can provide, or anyone on the board can provide a response. So I apologize. I hope that doesn't sound rude, but I'd be happy to follow up with you. You know I will. So that's not a problem. Mr. Crocco and Mrs. Crocco, thank you for the comments. You know, as we discussed, I know you had an initial meeting, then you requested another meeting with myself and Dr. Heineman. We all made ourselves available. I think we had about 8 people strong, certainly provided, you know, all the time that you had wanted to speak. I think, as your wife stated at that time, wow, it sounds like we agree in philosophy on what we're trying to do, which is great. We don't necessarily align ourselves with, you know, the statements. You know, in particular, we disagree in terms of our curriculum in alignment with the standards. They seem to be aligned. It's a question of what you think the standards are stating. We're not in complete agreement of that. Having said that, what we did share with you the way we ended the meeting was, coincidentally enough, we're right in the time for the revision process, and the arts are in the chute right now. So we will be, as we stated at the meeting, we'll be taking a look at the curriculum with the professionals over the summer, and taking a look at those standards and trying to see if there's anything that needs to be revised, as we do on a constant 5-year cycle, and we will continue to do that. But certainly, the arts are alive and well in Cranford. We are very big supporters of the arts at the board level, at the district level, at the school level, the parent level. We certainly look at them as a point of pride. And we'll continue to enhance programming because we think that's what our students deserve, and we think that that's an important component of their education. So I, again, appreciate your passion, and certainly would be happy to follow back up with you, you know, over the summer as we take a look at things. So thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Rubin. Does any of the board members have any comments? No? Okay. All right. We are going to move on to committee reports and old or new business. Does anybody have any committee reports? Please, Jess.
I have a curriculum committee report, and everybody should have received, thank you. Everybody should have received the minutes that were sent out. To give a brief review, the committee met and we discussed some textbook recommendations for U.S. History 1 and U.S. History 2 and entrepreneurship, as well as biology, chemistry, physics, forensic science, anatomy and physiology, medical terminology, nutrition, and then middle school sciences as well. Also, there's going to be a pilot program next school year at both middle schools for middle school theater and dance. Additional details to follow, but that's pretty exciting to hear. Then finally, we spoke about the dual credit partnerships. We spoke about one at our last board meeting. But in addition to that, one with Keene University Computer Science Partnership for AP Computer Science and AP Computer Science Principal Classes, as well as Hudson County Community College for Culinary Arts Program. And that's my report.
Thank you, Jess. Does anybody have any questions or comments? Good. Okay. Does anybody else have a report? Patrick.
I have two, Kurt. First, the policy committee met. Information was sent out. Policies and regs were distributed in advance of the meeting. They're on the agenda for first read tonight. Second, personnel committee also met. Personnel committee met on May 16th to discuss matters pertaining to a number of vacancies, including HR director, which is now no longer a vacancy, and other personnel matters. Thank you.
Thank you, Patrick. Does anybody have any questions for Patrick? Okay, do we have any other committee reports or old or new business? William.
Thank you. The School Safety and Wellness Committee met back on May 2nd, 2023. We discussed security cameras upgraded at the middle school. We also discussed mapping, the CRG mapping, which is now in the law. You have to have that. Visitor entry program will be up and running in the near future, probably next year. There'll be a lot of information going out regarding that visitor entry program prior to the school year next year. FirstNet, that is the communications between the principals. They have working cell phones now, and they can communicate directly with our safety partners, which is phenomenal. Wellness, Lisa Bernfeit gave an update. The district is going to move forward with some grief counseling for the teachers. They're going to train teachers to become grief counselors. This is just about grief. It's about anything, loss of life. It's other things as well. Also next year, they'll be setting up a wellness room at the high school for individuals who need time to regroup or work out issues. That was discussed. And the middle school pilot schedule is working very well. Our safety partners will end the year with a meeting, I guess, with Dr. Rubin to go over certain things. And next October, we'll also open that up to the public for Dr. Rubin, all our safety partners, to bring the public up to date on certain things that we're doing. AEDs were discussed as well. The maintenance of the AEDs were discussed and where we're storing them. So everyone got a copy of the notes. So that's all. Thank you.
Thank you, William. Does anybody have any questions for William? Okay, anybody else? No? All good? All right, thank you very much, everyone. All right, we are going to move on to the minutes. Patrick, will you please move the minutes?
Sure, I'd like to make a motion, consideration of the minutes of previous meetings, April 24th, 2023, regular monthly meeting, 7 p.m., April 24th, 2023, executive session, 8:50 p.m.
I second that.
Does anybody have any questions or comments on the minutes before we move them? Okay.
Mrs. Carbone.
Yes.
I have you. Mr. Dreyer.
Yes.
Mr. Hulse.
Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw.
Yes.
Mrs. Soltis.
Yes.
Mr. Petchow.
Yes.
Motion carries.
All right, we are going to move on to formal resolutions. Jess, you want to make sure that your mic is working? Because you got a long one here.
Try it a few times if it goes on fine.
Just hold it down, maybe.
there it goes.
It moves.
Oh, maybe. Okay. Okay. I'd like to make a motion to move resolution 2, business items. Resolution 3, approved revised budget statement 2022 to 2023. Resolution 4, board secretary's monthly certification, budgetary line item status. Resolution 5, 2023 to 2024 official newspapers and media source. Resolution 6, 2023 to 2024 depositories. Resolution 7, 2023 to 2024 student activity accounts. Resolution 8, authorization to open, close bank accounts and wire transfers. Resolution 9, authorization to issue warrants and electronic funds transfers. Resolution 10, petty cash fund for 2023 to 2024. Resolution 11, treasurer of school monies. Resolution 12, appointment of district purchasing agent. Resolution 13, authorizing contracts with certain approved state contract vendors pursuant to NJSA 18A:18A-10A. Resolution 14, renewal of continued participation in cooperative purchasing contracts. Resolution 15, authorizing the use of contracts with approved Pennsylvania Education Purchasing Program, PEPPM. Resolution 16, custodian of government records. Resolution 17, professional services reappoint board auditor. Resolution 18, professional services reappoint board attorney. Resolution 19, professional services reappoint medical services. Resolution 20, professional services designated person program, AHERA. Resolution 21, reappoint insurance broker. Resolution 22, residency investigator. Resolution 23, renewal of shared services agreement for school resource officers. Resolution 24, renew payroll and human resource management services contract. Resolution 25, renew technology services contract. Resolution 26, renew food service management contract. Resolution 27, joint transportation agreement with Morris Union Jointure Commission 2022-2023 school year. Resolution 28, renew transportation contracts, J&J Transportation. Resolution 29, renew transportation contract, Amaker and Porterfield Management LLC. Resolution 30, bid award pupil transportation services, Cranford High School Athletic Shuttle. Resolution 31, special education tuition contract renewal with Union County Educational Services Commission. Resolution 32, tuition agreement renewal with Union County Vocational Technical Schools. Resolution 33, environmental safety program agreement with Union County Educational Services Commission. Resolution 34, transportation jointure agreement with Union County Educational Services Commission. Resolution 35, participation in joint transportation program with Morris Union Jointure Commission. Resolution 36, participation in coordinated transportation with Educational Services Commission of New Jersey. Resolution 37, transportation jointure agreement with Burlington County Special Services School District. Resolution 38, non-public school nursing services. Resolution 39, non-public school textbook services. Resolution 40, non-public school security aid program. Resolution 41, non-public school technology initiative program. Resolution 42, non-public chapters 192 and 193 agreement. Resolution 43, IDEAB non-public schools agreement. Resolution 44, NJSIAA membership. Resolution 45, approval of travel expenditures. I believe revised resolution 46, I think.
Correct. The attachment. You're okay. Yes.
Revised. Okay. Yep. Field trip destination approval. And resolution 47, HIV decisions.
Second.
I need somebody to shut their mic off.
Can someone please get her right. Some water?
That's all right. So do we, does any board member have any questions on all that? Go ahead, William. Oh, hang on a sec. Let me shut mine off.
There you go. See, I got it down.
Three
at a time. I just want to make a comment. Thank you, Mr. Carfagno. I know this was a topic in the past. The bid award number 30 for the Cranford High School shuttle. Thank you so much for getting that done. I know that went out a couple of times, so thank you. Appreciate your hard work on that. Thank you.
You're welcome. And as William said, I want to jump up and down. We do have a bid award recommendation for tonight for next year for the shuttle. Our new bus that we ordered should be here July or August. It's still kind of on time. You see on the resolutions, too, our other transportation agreements that are on for renewals. So hopefully we'll have everything in place for September. It seems like it. The special ed routes are still out there for the placements and in district just through these co-ops, but nothing's come to my attention that is going to be problematic, and I hope I don't eat those words. So that's working out pretty good so far. So thank you for your comments, and hopefully we can have a smoother year.
Thank you, William. Do we have any other comments or questions?
Actually, one comment.
Hang on, let me shut my mic off and you can turn yours on. There
you go. I just noticed if you look at a lot of these authorizations, it's giving Bob the authorization to do a lot in the district. So just much appreciation everything that you do.
Thanks, appreciate it.
So, Jess, I know that was cruel and unusual punishment for a first-year board member, but I thought you did great. So, thank you. Let's take a vote.
Mrs. Carbone.
Yes to all except abstain to 30.
Okay. Mr. Dreyer.
Someone turn this off.
Okay. Yes to all, abstain from 47.
Okay. Mr. Hulse.
Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Abstain 21, yes to the remainder.
Okay. Mrs. Shaw.
Yes to all, abstain 47.
Okay. Mrs. Soltis.
Yes.
Mr. Petchow.
Hang on, let's do the mic first.
Oh.
Yes.
I heard her. We have a yes. Okay, Mr. Petchow.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Motion carried on all.
Thank you. Lisa, will you please move resolutions 48 through 53?
I'd like to move resolution 48, approval of secondary school partnership agreement. Resolution 49, approval K through 12 core books. Resolution 50, approval of curricula. Resolution 51, curriculum writing projects. Resolution 52, guidance and counseling program. Resolution 53, Gifted and Talented Pathways to Excellence program.
Second.
Thank you. Any board member have any questions or comments before we move on? All right. I just wanted to also, we've been talking about this a lot lately, but resolution number 48, see if I can find it again, because I just lost my spot. Approval of a secondary school partnership agreement. Dr. Heinemann, can you give us any update on that, please?
Oh,
nope. Try Jen's.
We share here.
Thank you for engaging this cooperative team exercise.
Yeah. Am I okay?
No, it's
no, something.
Maybe Bob shut your door.
It's a mist.
Yeah, it was that. Okay. Yes, so Hudson County Community College, that was a partnership thanks to Anna Maria Bellino, who made that partnership up with our match, pairing up our culinary program at the high school with Hudson County Community College. And so students are able to earn credits, dual enrollment, by taking the courses at the high school and also taking having dual enrollment at the community college. Why is that still doing that?
It's a radioactive mug you have next.
Maybe move them up. Thank you, Dr. Heinemann. I appreciate that update. And I know it's been a point of emphasis, and Mr. Hulse and other board members have brought it up prior, that it's great to see our students and, of course, their parents, too, being able to get college, not just college courses, but college credits while they're still in high school. Yes, please.
I'll try this one.
I got
2 points at me now. So I had mentioned to someone before, but what I would have the admins do next year is do a presentation on all of the courses that we've had partnerships with, because we've added a few throughout COVID, like over the years, and they kind of come in you know, dribs and drabs. So I want to get them, put them all together, and kind of share with the whole board what we have available for students, because it's a pretty good set of robust offerings now. And part of what they look for when we're looking at our school performance reports is the number of 11th and 12th grade students that we have enrolled in dual enrollment courses. So what we're looking to do is have a lot of variety so that we have students with those options to get credits and leave Cranford High School with transcript credits, not just potential credits, but actual transcript credits. So next year in the fall, I hope to present to the board on all the opportunities available to kids.
Thank you very much. Appreciate that. Any other board members have any comments or questions? William.
Dr. Heinemann, just real quick, how are we getting those that information out to the students so they're aware about it? That's how are we doing that? I'm sorry.
Yeah, no. So he just wants to keep using the
mic. Yeah, I feel like people are messing with me now at this point. Perfect.
Definitely not.
I know. So it's generally in the program of studies. So the program of studies delineates exactly where they're offered, and we have kind of like little markers for a course that a kid would know, oh, this one can be dual enrollment. And then we notify the kids when they enroll that course. This one's a little different because it came after the fact. So students have already enrolled. So what guidance is doing is reaching out to those students now and saying, okay, this is an offer now available for next year. If you'd like to do it, just look at those kids directly. So unfortunately, maybe a student might have taken it if they knew, but you know, that's, you know, way back in February when we do that. So this was not locked up until now. And sometimes, unfortunately, universities, the wheels turn pretty slowly. So when we form partnerships, it's a long process. I mean, the one with Kane probably took 7 months to get fully buttoned up. So it's not like you make a phone call and 3 weeks later you're done. It's a pretty lengthy process, but that's how we get the kids, whether it's before or after the fact.
Bob, we're ready to go.
Mrs. Carbone.
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer.
Yes.
Mr. Hulse.
Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw.
Yes.
Mrs. Soltis.
Yes.
Mr. Petchow.
Yes.
Motion carried.
Thank you. Patrick, will you please move resolutions 54 through 58?
Sure. I'd like to make a motion to move resolution 54, purchase of professional consultation services. Motion, Resolution 55, extended school year out-of-district placement of special education student. Resolution 56, additional special education extended school year appointed non-certified staff. Resolution 57, revised extended school year out-of-district placement of special education student. And Resolution 58, revised out-of-district placement of special education student.
I second.
Anybody have any questions on 54 through 58? Okay.
Mrs. Carbone.
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer.
Yes.
Mr. Hulse.
Yes, abstain for 54.
Okay. Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw.
Yes.
Mrs. Soltis.
Yes.
Mr. Petcha.
Yes.
Motion carried.
Thank you. Sue, will you please move resolutions 59 through 87 and 64, I'm sorry, 59 and 64, both revised.
I would like to make a motion to move 59, approval of substitutes and home instruction, revised. 60, retirement. 61, resignations. 62, leaves of absence. 63, appointments. 64, revised staff reassignments. 65, spring volunteer coaching appointment. 66, fall coaching appointment. 67, fall volunteer coaching appointments. 68, 6-period salary adjustments. 69, additional reappointment lunchroom assistance. 70, miscellaneous additional assignment lunchroom. 71, miscellaneous additional assignment nursing. 72, miscellaneous additional assignment orchestra musician. 73, miscellaneous additional assignment adapt. 74, miscellaneous additional assignment athletic physicals. 75, miscellaneous additional assignment band camp. 76, substitute rates. 77, extra assignments, fee schedule for events. 78, school counselors, July and August, 2023. 79, school nurses, July, August, 2023. 80, child study team, July, August, 2023. 81, CAP, CAMP, LEAP staff, July, August, 2023. 82, appointment of facilitators. 83, appointment of anti-bullying facilitators. 84, social-emotional learning facilitators. 85, additional assignment district webmaster. 86, school-based webmaster. 87, PSAT, SAT, ACT, preparation, enrichment testing program. And that's it.
Second.
I can hear you, okay? That's all that matters. I hear you.
There's no need to yell.
I had to ask. No, listen. Does anybody have any questions on comments? Well, actually, before we go to questions or comments, Bob, you're going to talk about the two revised?
Yes. Okay. Resolution 59, on the back page, there was two substitutes added for classroom, lunchroom, and clerical. That were added after the packet went out. That's on the back of the resolution. And Resolution 64, item number 2, was added. There's an opening in the 5th grade at Hillside Avenue School. So that was added to the agenda after it went out.
Thank you, Bob. Anybody else have any other questions or comments?
I just want to congratulate Joanne on her retirement. Once again, right, 25 and 3/4 years of service, not uncommon to see that on retirements. And we look forward to recognizing her at the next board meeting where we celebrate the rest of the retirees. So,
thank you, Dr. Rubin. Appreciate that. Anybody else? Okay.
Thank you. Mrs. Carbone.
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer.
Yes.
Mr. Hulse.
Yes, abstain from 66.
Okay. Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw.
Yes.
Mrs. Soltis.
Yes.
Mr. Petchak?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Thank you. Brett, will you please move resolutions 88 through 96?
Yes, I'd like to move resolution 88, abolish policies. Resolution 89, policies and regulations for the first reading. Resolution 90, approval of policies. Resolution 91, approval of district job descriptions. Resolution 92, code of conduct. Resolution 93, approval of district organizational chart. Am I going to 96?
Yes.
Resolution 94, evaluation model certified staff. Resolution 95, evaluation model principals, assistant principals. And resolution 96, rescind appointment.
Second.
Does any board member have any questions or comments on those resolutions? Okay.
Mrs. Carbone?
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer?
Yes.
Mr. Hulse?
Yes.
Mr. Lynch?
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw?
Yes.
Mrs. Soltis?
Abstain from 89, yes to all others.
Okay. Mr. Petchak?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Thank you. Okay, we have previously moved number 97, hand carried. So that is it for our formal resolutions. We are up to our second audience participation. If anybody would like to come up to the mic and ask a question or make any comments. Okay, seeing none, we do need executive session. Patrick, will you please move us into executive session for personnel?
Sure. I move that the Board of Education recess to an executive session for consideration of issues dealing with personnel. Action may be taken on these items when the board later returns to public session. Minutes of the executive session may be made available to the public after the reasons for non-disclosure no longer exist.
Second.
Thank you. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. We're going to take a brief recess and then go into executive session. Thank you, everyone.
Have a good evening. Thank you.
Thank you.